Thank you for joining us on SAP Developer News, where our developer advocates will get you up to speed with some great information.
This week, Conversational AI held its latest show and tell on the new features for its November release. Among the features are these five. You can now use the SAP Conversational AI mobile SDK to integrate chatbots into your iOS apps. In addition to an open source Swift package, there's now a dedicated channel specifically for iOS apps. With SSO enabled, you now have a user object that you can use in scripting and to set the memory. Included in the information are role collections from BTP and groups from the identity provider. With the client, with the web client, you can now detect the user's time zone, and you can format dates and time using that time zone and not just the UTC offset. There's also a bunch of API improvements, including new and improved APIs for controlling the versions and environments, as well as new options for the deletion of conversational logs so you can conform to GDPR requirements. And finally, FAQ chatbots now support a bunch of additional languages, including Arabic, Chinese simplified and traditional, Italian, Japanese, Korean, Dutch, Polish, Portuguese, and Russian. All of these features are expected to be available November 13th. For more information, you can see the show and tell on the SAP Conversational AI YouTube channel, and you can follow my blogs or all of the SAP Conversational AI blogs in the SAP community.
We're closing the Data and Analytics Week, aka Week 5 of Devtoberfest today. The week was fully packed with engaging Meet the Author sessions of best-selling data and analytics books, a Meet the Expert session, and presentations about various topics such as data science, enterprise data landscapes, and the history of data visualization. Of course, there were tutorials to complete to earn points for the contest. And last but not least, two Fun Friday sessions focusing on how to teach kids coding are scheduled for today. As week 5 is over, this also means that Devtoberfest is almost over. But we kept the best, or at least in my opinion, best week for the end. Next week will be all about front-end development. I'll kick the week off on Monday with some general tips on how you can measure and improve the performance of your web apps. And with this session, I'll also open the coding challenge of the week. Then we'll have two sessions on Tuesday. One is about micro frontends and the other about GraphQL. Both sessions will cover what these buzzwords mean and what you can do to use them in your day-to-day job. On Thursday, Philip will open the European Day with a session about the Web Components Standard and how to build your own Web Components, similar to what SAP did with the UI5 Web Components. Speaking of which, in case you use the UI5 Web Components for React, you don't want to miss Michelle's presentation later that Thursday. She will introduce you to popular libraries that help you to do proper state management in React-based applications. Also, make sure to have a look at all the points earning activities before we close the contest on Friday. The second important appointment you need to keep in mind for next Friday is our Fun Friday pub quiz with the entire Developer Advocates team. Make sure to tune in either for the morning session or the afternoon session, whatever fits your schedule best. You see, the next week is fully packed and will transition perfectly over to SAP TechEd, which starts the week after.
The start of this week saw the 21.11 release of SAP Fiori Tools with a whole load of new features based upon feedback from you. The aim of the SAP Fiori Tools team is to make it easier to build SAP Fiori apps and this release certainly delivers on that. First off, there's a new application information page, which gives you all the essential information about your project. Then there's the integrated mock server for all your offline testing needs. There are more preview options for testing. And last but certainly not least, there are more deployment options in the deploy CLI tool. Who doesn't love a great CLI tool, right? Anyway, for more details, check out Ashley Tung's blog post.
We are less than 2 weeks away from the start of SAP TechEd 2021. If you aren't registered yet, why not? This is the premier technical event for the SAP technical community and a great free educational opportunity. Once you're signed up for TechEd, you want to be sure to check out some of the important things that the developer advocates are going to bring your way, specifically for our developer audience as part of SAP TechEd. On day two, at the start of the day, we will have the developer keynote. Similar to last year, this is going to be a keynote designed by developers for developers with lots of coding and demos. And we can't wait to show you some of the fun aspects that we have planned for the developer keynote. Also new this year for TechEd, during the entire 49 hours of the event, the developer advocate team will be manning a central chat. So whether you have technical questions, follow up to something that you've seen within TechEd, or you want to discuss general career opportunities or other aspects of being a developer in the SAP ecospace, you'll have the opportunity to chat with us live all throughout the event. So we look forward to seeing you in less than 2 weeks at SAP TechEd 2021.